Hey guys!
And gals!
So here's another overview of the latest additions to VCV Rec, and we will actually start with the new public beta of the VCV library. It's still not possible to add modules here, so you can still not download from this until VCV version 2 is out, but still we can look at the different modules, which is amazing. So we have pictures for each module, and we can also search with a tag option here, so we can look, for example, and we can search for all the different samplers in VCV. So now we get all the different samplers and their picture and from who they are, and later when version 2 will come out, we can also add them to the VCV library. So it's quite cool. If you're looking for a module, specific module, and you don't know where to find it, you can just look here in the tags, and there are quite a lot of samplers. This is really nice. Another thing we can do, if we go to plugins, we can look here for all the different plugins, let's say by computer scare, right? And now we can see all the different plugins it has, and if I click one, we go and we get more details, which is quite cool. You can go to the website, you can go to the manual, and you can see the source code, you can see the license. Also, by the way, in the library before, you can also search, you can also scan through premium, free, and open source, which is quite cool. So this is something new that will come out of beta, I guess, with version 2. Have fun. Okay, and here we have new modules from the Vox Glitch collection. We have Auto Break and Grain Engine, again, a granular mangling of your samples. Here I have a sort of a drum groove. And I have also, I recorded this sample as a sample and upload it into Grain Engine and Auto Break. Let's start with Grain Engine. So it will sound like this. You can change the length of the grains. You can pan them, you can change the envelope, you can change the pitch. You can generate the grains through the spawn input. And of course, I'm also modulating the position here. And here we have Auto Break, which will sound like this. So it will take the sample, chop it into different sections, and you can sequence those sections. And all together it will sound like this. Just adding some quirkiness to the rhythm. And of course you don't have to use this with drums, you can use this with everything. Yeah, so go get granular. Okay, and here there's a new module in the Modular Fungi collection, which is a collection of blanks. Nothing special, but here there is a new one that is all about color coding. So I love to use color coding when I build patches. That way I can see exactly what is going where and why. It just makes the patch more organized. I really recommend doing this. So here I have, this is what I use. I use red for audio. I use blue, as you can see here, red for audio. I use blue for triggers, gates, and clocks. I use yellow for pitch information or volt per octave. And I use green for modulation. And of course, this depends on where the cable is going. So here, for example, we have a yellow one because it's going to the volt per octave input. But the second row is green because it's modulating the feedback amount. So again, it can really help you keeping your patches organized. Go check it out. And here we have the Nano collection in VCV coming from Hardware. Beautiful collection. We have Quart, which are four envelope generators, which can go also into audio rate. And here, for example, I'm using this as a code. I have each channel set to a different note. We have MAR, which is a mixer. So here I'm mixing those voices. We have FONT, which is a beautiful and really wet and crunchy filter. And we have ALT, which is three VCAs, or four VCAs actually, and three of them have a control over the levels. And we have a few beautiful blanks here of the different overtones, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. Very nice. So here I have a small patch. I have this chord being mixed and going to clouds, and this will sound like this. Nothing special, but I'm also sending those voices to the VCA, and I'm using another quart to modulate the levels, and I'm triggering this quart from the gate sequencer, and this I'm sending to a delay, and the delay has a feedback loop with the font, with the filter, and I think this font filter is amazing for the feedback loop of a blob, the chrono blob. This will sound like this. Oh yeah, here you can hear this feedback loop of the delay. Very nice. And here I have a knock as a kick, bass drum. Oh yeah. Very nice, beautiful modules. Again, go check them out. And if you're interested, they're also available as hardware. Have fun. Okay, so here we have new modules in the Count Modula collection, which I think, if I'm not mistaken, is the biggest collection in VCV. Maybe after Nisci can be. But as you can see, it got a major update with lots and lots of new modules. So let's just zoom in here a bit and see what we have. We have the Polychances, which is a polyphonic Bernoulli gate. We have an attenuverter, we have a polyphonic gate to trigger. So if you have a gate, you want to convert it into a trigger when the gate is high, or when it starts, when it ends, or when both. You can do this also polyphonically now. We have a polyphonic voltage controlled switch. We have a polyphonic voltage controlled polarizer. So again, you can attenuvert polyphonic signals. We have the polyphonic logic. We have a polyphonic manual CV. So you can send offset into different polyphonic or polyphony channels. We have the signal manifold. So you can send signals into different polyphonic channels again. We have expanders. Gate expanders for the 8 and 16 step sequencers. We have breakout, so we can split a polyphonic signal. We have the polymute. We can mute different channels in the polyphonic signals. We have the polyphonic minimum maximum. We have the voltage scaler. So if you have a certain signal and you want to limit it, we can do this with this module. We have 8 times 16 step gate sequencer, and we have also an 8 times 8 steps version of it. We have also a 16 step sequencer and an expander of it, so you can add more channels to the 16 step sequencer. We have also a master reset. Yes, a lot of modules we are still not done. A master reset. So you can reset your clocks. And here I have a small patch with more new modules. We have a Euclidean sequencer, a beautiful Euclidean sequencer with an expander also for CV. So you can create rhythms and pitch information. We have again the 8x8 step gate sequencer. And we have an 8 step sequencer also again with expanders. And you can see you can just stack them. So here I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 channels of 8 step sequences, which is quite cool. So let's start here with what we have. I have here, let me just mute everything and we will go voice by voice. Let's see, what do we have here? Here we have another one. Okay, let's start actually with a kick. I think it's a kick. Yeah. So I have here tremor 2, and it's receiving a gate from the end of cycle output of the Euclidean sequencer. So this is the first voice. Then we have the macro oscillator 2 in chord mode, receiving a trigger from the hits. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4 hits in a 14 length sequence. And here we have also the rest. So whenever there is no hit, so here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 actually, we get also triggers from here, and this is triggering the hi-hat. Let's see if this is the second. Yeah. So you can create really nice rhythms with this, and you can also create pitch information. So let's have a listen. I hope it's this. Oh yeah. So now you can choose from where you will get a clock, from the beat, so from the hits, from the clock, from the input, or from the rests. And you will have pitch information that is going, in this case of course, to the FM operator. And they have here also four channels on the 8x8 gate sequencer, which is triggering some drums. Oh yeah. And I have also the 8-step sequencer with another expander. And I just connected more expanders just so you can see that they are also working, so you can stack them. And this is sequencing two energy oscillators, but it's in one shot mode. So it will play one shot until it will receive a reset trigger into the reset. This is how it will sound like. Which is really nice. So it's playing randomly. A one shot sequence. Oh yeah. So really nice new modules from Count Modula. Go check them out. Okay, and here we have two new modules from Vult. One Lepsus you can find in the Mysteries collection. It's a Euclidean or a non-Euclidean rhythm generator. It's really nice. I have also a video about it. I will put a link in the description to this video. And there is also Disjoint, which is in the free collection of Vult, which is a DJ style filter. So to the left you have low pass, to the right you have high pass. I have here a patch going, I have a knock being triggered by the clock, and I have Lepsus generating rhythms for different oscillators. I have here Bleak and Basel, and they are all being mixed through knobs here, going through some delay. It will sound like this. And of course I can change the length. Here I have 12 step sequence and can change the hits or the pulses. And you can see it's all here. And it has other really nice features. And here the disjoint, I can just play it. Something like this, I don't know. I'm no DJ. But you can get really creative with this filter, so it's really nice. It has also a really nice resonance, and of course it's Vult, so it sounds amazing. So go check them out. Okay, and here we have the Triggerfish modules finally back in VCV. Beautiful modules. We have the Triggerfish VCA with two different inputs, linear and exponential, that you can use both with, like I'm doing here, with two different envelopes. We have slope and the 4x slope that will add drift and this human feel to your sound, to your patches, to your oscillators, which is amazing. And we have also the Vanderpol oscillator, which is also really interesting. I have here a patch going, I have the gate sequencer triggering the two different envelopes that are going to the VCA. I have here the Vanderpol oscillator and another oscillator from Bog Audio going into it, going into its input. And I have here another sequence with two VCOs, and they are, the sequence itself, the CV, the pitch information is going through a slope, and I'm adding really lots of drift to it, so it's nice and moving and always in motion. It sounds like this. You can really hear how it's moving. Really how it's drifting out of tune. And the oscillator, the Vanderpol oscillator, is also weird and quirky and nice. Okay, so go check them out. They are really nice and can add lots of human feel to your patches. And here we have a new developer, the Moog, with a really nice sequencer, the Moog Network, and also a sort of a clock divider, the Moog Nexus clock divider, counter, what you want to call it. Here it's sequencing, as you can see, it's quite quirky and fun. It's sequencing an FM operator. I have a few here that are FMing each other. going through some delay, it sounds like this. And you can see the sequence is moving in all sorts of ways. It's also polyphonic, by the way. So it's really nice, go have fun. And here we have new modules from Mokba Modular, the utilities collection. We have a split and merge and a mixer for your polyphonic signals, which is quite cool, with two expanders, so you can have up to 16 channels. We have a sample and hold, 8 channels of sample and hold with probability per channel, which is amazing. So you can add probability, you can divide the clock, you can use a main clock or trigger each of them separately. And you can also, as you can see what I'm doing here, I'm also merging a few of them into a polyphonic signal, which is also quite cool. We have also the tube, which is a nice saturation module. We have also a spreader for polyphonic signals, and you can choose if the result will be monophonic or it will be polyphonic, as you can see here. And we have also a DC blocker filter if you want to get rid of DC signals. This is the tool for you. Here I have 4 channels from the sample and hold generating random pitch information with probability also, so they will not always generate a new signal, going through a quantizer, polyphonic quantizer, and a polyphonic oscillator, again, Mokba Modular. It's going through the tube, so I can add some saturation, and it's going through the spreader, so I'm spreading the signals left and right in the stereo field. It sounds like this. Also using another channel of the sample and hold. By the way, I didn't mention it, but you can change the range of each channel from negative 10 to positive 10 and everything in between. So this is also quite cool. So you have 8 different channels of sample and hold with probability, with clock divider, and with range settings, and you can merge them in the polyphonic signal, which is beautiful. Very nice. Go check this out. And here we have 2 new modules from Good Shepherd. We have Hurdle, which is a sort of a gate skipper with a probability input. So according to the signal you send here in the probability input, there is a chance that it will skip the gate, the incoming gate. And here we have also Stall, which is a sort, again, of a clock divider, I guess. So it will split the gate you send into it according to the CV you send to it, so you can see it's a sort of a clock divider, I guess. Here I have a small patch going. I have the SEC3 sending its gate through the gate skipper, and I'm also modulating the probability with sample and hold, and this is going to a plats and to a delay. This is how it sounds like. So you can hear that we are skipping the gates. I have all of the gates here on. So you can create really nice results with it. And add, again, probability and randomness to your patches. And here we have a new module from JW, which is called Striker, I guess. And it's a clock that will output by default 16th notes, but you can change this also in the right click menu. And it has also something that's called OSC, I think it has something to do with Ableton. I don't know, I'm not an Ableton user, but if this is something you're looking for, here it is. You can use it with Striker. You can change the BPM in all sorts of ways. So you can go 100 seconds or hundreds, not seconds, just hundreds, tenths, ones, and also after the point. You can change also the range. You have BPM output, BPM input, fader. You can change the modulator fader. Yeah, it's a really nice clock. If this is what you are looking for, here it is. Okay, more good news. 21 kilohertz is back in VCV. We have the pitch tools here that we can transpose your sequences, pitch information, whatnot. We have the amazing palm loop oscillator with exponential FM and linear FM and the sub octave outputs here. And we have the tachyon or tachyon entangler, which is also really nice. Oscillator with sync, FM, chaos, whatnot, can create really crazy sounds. Heavy or small patch going. Entropia is sending once a sequence to the sequential switch, and once again through the pitch tools with 7 semitones up, and again to the sequential switch. This is sequencing the palm loop oscillator, which is amazing, going once directly with the sub octave to the mixer, once through a filter. And let's have a listen to this first. And I have also this tachyon entangler making some weird, crazy stuff here. Let's fade it in. Oh yeah. Oh man. Very nice, very nice. I'm really happy that those modules are back in VCV. Yes, yes, go have a look. Okay, and here we have another new developer, the Non-Linear Circuits, which is actually, I think, also the same developer from Hetrick CV. So we have 3 modules. We have Bools, which is a 4-channel Boolean module, Boolean logic module. In the right-click menu, you can choose which logic function you want. Here I have it set to end. And I'm sending it 3 different signals from the gate sequencer. So only when all of them are playing, you can see I have here one step with probability. So only when all of them are playing, it will trigger one FM operator. And also here we have a slew output with the slew control, which is also really nice. We have Neuron, which I'm still not so sure what it's doing. I have to experiment with it a bit more, but it looks amazing. And we have the Squid Exon, which is a sort of a shift register, I guess. So what I'm doing here, I'm triggering the 3 FM operators. Again, one of them is only when all 3 are triggered. And this is going once to the mixer, but it's also going to the shift register. And I'm using it as pitch information through a VCA to another FM operator. And again, I'm mixing here also 3 triggers. And this time I'm using the OR function. So never mind which one is playing or all of them are playing. Yeah, you will receive a trigger. And this is triggering the last voice. It will sound like this. So I'm using the oscillators as a voice, but also as pitch information through the shift register. Which is quite cool. So go check them out and have fun. Okay, and here we have 2 new modules from Impromptu. We have a smaller version of Clocked with 4 channels, but without swing, pulse width, and delay. But still, if you want a smaller clock, this is the clock for you. And we have also Chord Key, which is almost like 12-key. Again, in Prompt 2, you can create codes with up to 4 different notes and also sequence them. So here I'm sequencing it, for example, with an ADDR sequencer that is receiving a trigger from the gate sequencer, again in Prompt 2. So I have 2 different chords going here, triggering or sequencing energy polyphonically. You can also merge the 4 notes to a polyphonic signal, and this is going through some delay. It will sound like this. One chord. The second chord. I have here also a nice bass drum to accompany it. Oh yeah. Chill. Very nice. Okay, so 2 new modules from Impromptu 2. And that was it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please hit the like button. If you enjoy what I do, consider becoming a Patreon. If you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe and hit the bell. And have a good one.